Ago. You need to know a little bit of history, Kumasi history. That is very important. Kumasi means the kum tree has germinated. The kum tree has germinated. I was talking about Okonfanochi. Okonfanochi was a wonderful traditional priest who promulgated the golden stool from the skies. And what he did was that when he came to this place, when he grew from a place known as Aukugwa in the eastern region, he came to the Asante region. And then when he came here, he became a friend to one of the kings of Asante kingdom. At that time, Asantes have 11 kingdoms. So when he came, he said, you know what, I'm to help you to bring all the 11 kingdoms together to have one kingdom under one paramountcy. As a result of that, he told them that they should go and fast for 30 days. All the chiefs should fast for 30 days. And then on the 30th day, they will meet at a place. That place is still there. And the time came, all of them fasted and they met at a place. And when they met, the people were waiting for the traditional priest to come. All of a sudden, the man appeared dancing mystically, conjuring things, saying some things, moving here and there. He got to a place that he stopped. According to legend, he stopped and started commanding some, saying some words. All of a sudden, the weather became very tense, as if it's going to rain. Then he stood at a point and he started saying, calm down, calm down, calm down. And then at that time, he has already informed the chiefs that whoever the ancestor chooses you, there was something that is going to touch you. And when that thing touches you, meaning the ancestors have selected you out of the 11 kingdoms to become the head of all the chiefs. All of them accepted. So according to legend, as they were sitting there, then something from the skies came and touched the laps or stood on the laps of one of the king, Nana Osaitutu, meaning that Osaitutu has been selected by the ancestors to be the custodian of the Ashanti kingdom. If it were to be in the modern day, everybody would have to append his signature. But in those days, there's nothing like a signature. But there was, in a traditional way, what he did was that he collected a little bit of all the 11 chiefs' hair. He collected their fingernails, cut your fingernail, and then he also asked them of their black stool. Black stool is a seat that, or a stool that, when your predecessor passed on, there's a stool, you have to paint it black, write his name, and put in a stool room. The stool room is very dark. So that's why you call it the dark or the black stool. They paint it black and keep it there. He asked of a black stool, they brought it, he split all the black stools, paint it, add the hair and then the fingernails to it, and then we also add palm wine and gave it to each and everyone to sip it. If you sip it, meaning you have accepted Nana Osaitutu as the king of the Ashanti or the overlord king of the Ashanti kingdom. And all of them accepted that. The residue, he dug the ground and put it there and buried it and prophesied that some years to come, that residue is going to heal a lot of people from far and near. Over 300-400 years later, that was the place that Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, at that time Kwame Nkrumah wasn't there, but that was the place that they selected to build a hospital. And now it's a teaching hospital. God willing, maybe tomorrow we'll definitely see the teaching hospital. So his prophecy came to pass. He does a lot of wonders. He collected a palm fruit, threw it into the air, and all of them line, straight line, as if a line has been drawn. And then he said, this is the fingers. It will grow. This one will be this, this one will be this, the middle one will be tall, the smallest one will be here. And every, he said a whole lot. And those signs are still there that you can see. Now, the residue that the diagram that they put there, he has a sword and he put the sword on it. And he prophesied that no human being will be able to exhume the sword. The day human being exhumed this sword, that will be the collapse of the Ashanti Kingdom. There are lots and lots of people who have tried to touch it. I learned that there was a boxer who came. Even Muhammad Ali was here and he saw it. He took him there, he saw it, he touched it. A lot of people tried to pull the sword out, but it wasn't possible. When they were building the hospital, there was one of the foundations supposed to pass where the sword is. They tried to dig around it to remove the sword. They will start from the morning till evening. The more you dig, the more the sword goes down. When they leave it the following day, the sword appears again. So they decided to fence it and leave it like that. Still, the sword is there and no human being has been able to uproot it. After he did all this, there's a certain tree. I don't know the botanical name. It's called the kum tree. The kum tree. Some people said that tree locally is called Nyamidia. Nyamidia means God tree. It's a wonderful tree that when a child is sick, you just get a leaf or the stem or root, put it in the water, take the root, and then you mix it with the water. Shake it, and then use it to bath the child, and the child will be okay. So they said it's a blessing tree that God has given to us, hence the name Nyami means God, God tree. But this one is a kum tree. And now we know our chief, where the paramountcy is going to be, no one knows. But with the traditional priest, he knows. So what he did was that he planted this tree at two places, and he said one is going to germinate and one is going to die. The one that germinates is called Kum Esi. The one that died is called Kum Ewu. Ewu means is dead. So where the tree died is called Kum Ewu. Right now there's a town called Kum Ewu, and with this place the Kum tree germinated. So Kum Esi. Kumasi means Kum Esi, Kum Esi. Hence the name Kumasi, Kum Dianu Esi. The Kum tree has germinated. The Kum tree has germinated. That is how we came by the name Kumasi. Is the paramountcy of the Ashanti king. So the overlord of Ashanti, he lives in Kumasi. Kumasi and other towns, we have big towns, Kumewu, we have Mampong, we have Jaso, we have a lot of places. Now we are at a very important area. You can see a lot of people. Today is a market day, so people bring their foodstuffs from far and near to sell and to buy. People travel from far away, comes to this place to buy. This is a Jaso. And when you mention a just